Holy shit. It was true. It was all true. Before we get into it, spoilers, of course, episode 5, WandaVision, let's talk about it. So, pretty much this episode was where we start to see everything sort of be deconstructed and we're starting to learn the reality of things now. So, one of the biggest things I think that we learned early on in the episode is Agnes might just be who we're all thinking she is. So, since WandaVision was first announced and we heard about Agnes, I said this is going to be Agatha. And now it's looking like that's going to be the case as we hear Agnes talk about having tricks up her sleeve. And it seems that Agnes is the only one that is sort of participating with Wanda and having this show go on as she stumbles upon a moment where the script doesn't go as it was supposed to go. And she tells Wanda, should we take her from the top? This is where Vision starts to pretty much be like, what the hell's going on here? And so what we see then happen is the kids actually age from babies to like 6-year-olds and then eventually 10-year-old as well. And everything that's happening now, Vision is sort of picking up clues that this isn't exactly how reality is. And he starts to really feel like there is something much more going on here than he is being led on. Now, in the reality of things back on the Earth outside of Westview, we see that now they're trying to sort of figure out how will they be able to communicate with Wanda since they know she is the one behind all of this. And then we are shown and told that Wanda actually had infiltrated S.W.O.R.D. 9 days prior and actually took the corpse of Vision from there. And this is pretty much where we can assume that this is why she started all of this, because she can reanimate his corpse here and have it be freely and walking. So we can pretty much set aside the whole this is taking place in her head and these people aren't real, because we realize now that they really are real, as Vision has a moment with one of his co-workers where he breaks him out of, I would say, the curse or the hex of Wanda. And he's pretty much like, I don't know what's going on. I want to see my family. It hurts so much. She's controlling me. And Vision's just like, what the hell is going on? And so while all this is happening, the family actually gets a dog, and then eventually the dog runs away. And what we see happen as well is that during this time, they sent a drone in to try and talk to Wanda, and this just pisses her off because they, unbeknownst to other people, it actually had a weapon in it. So she comes out and she's basically like, I don't know what all of you want to do, but why can't y'all just let me be living in peace? And I'm just gonna say it, Wanda was freaking bamf in this, like insanely, like crazy, like she just looked like she was about to tear him up. Monica tries to talk to her, but Wanda doesn't have, like, she's like, I ain't talking to you, I'm done with y'all, this is too much. And she pretty much just goes back and's like, this is my reality, leave me alone. And so we see then that she goes back and we see Vision sort of confront her about all of this as well. Vision's trying to figure out what exactly is going on and what is Wanda hiding from him, what is beyond Westview, and why isn't everything adding up, like what is the truth here. And so what we see happen is Wanda's just trying to sort of calm him down and trying to sort of bring him at ease, but he's not having it. And then out of nowhere, a doorbell rings and Vision's like, you went ahead and did that, didn't you? You're just trying to distract. And she's like, no, I didn't. When she opens the door, Pietro. But it's not Aaron. It's actually Evan Peters Pietro. And we hear Darcy say, she just recast Pietro, which is pretty much, I think, them saying, this is going to be the new Quicksilver in the MCU, right? And so I thought that that was very interesting that we were going to get to see Pietro actually join here. And I'm excited to see. And so I'm excited to see what exactly this is going to mean coming forward now, as we will have a new Quicksilver in town and if we will see him beyond WandaVision. So very, very intense ending right there. Now, one of the things I find interesting is that this is like something they made clear in this episode, I think, is all of these people are real people. And so this is the real Pietro. This isn't like some like concoction she made up in her head. This Pietro now exists in this reality. And so I think that WandaVision really is going to be this thing that's going to open up all these different realities. As I've said before, I think by the end of it, we're going to see like Spider-Man's, Doctor Strange, all of that come into these realities and just sort of them dealing with it in the upcoming films. As I keep saying in every single video, Mr. Feige has said that WandaVision, Doctor Strange, Spider-Man tell a whole story. And I think that that whole story is going to deal with multiverse and ripping all of that, because I think that Wanda was able to sort of start that rip in the universe already and sort of get the X-Men in here now. Now, will we see an X-Men villain sort of show up behind Pietro? I think that's a very strong possibility of something we could see happening later down the road that they talk about and explain that this is why this happened. And so I'm very much so excited to see that. Now, I'm more than 100% sure now that Agnes is actually Agatha now. After this episode, it is very clear, because all of the other civilians and everybody else has no clue what's going on. They're sort of under a spell, but Agnes seems to sort of know what is quote-unquote happening. And even when the kids found their dog actually died and Agnes was holding it and the kids were telling Wanda to bring it back to life, she was sort of like trying to egg her on and be like, tell me the truth, you know, like spit it out, what is happening. So I thought that that's interesting right there. Another question many people have is, now that we know that these people are real, are the kids real as well? And I think that answer is yes. I think the kids will come out of this at the end. As I said before, I do believe Mephisto is the main villain here, and I think we are going to see him try to sort of take one of the kids' bodies and claim it as his own in an effort to come into the our reality, of course. And I think that's something that Stephen Strange is going to try and stop right there. But overall, the Evan Peters thing, as I said, was one of the things that got leaked. And it was something that many of us knew already from last week. But still, seeing him back was just like icing on the cake. And that joke at the end when he said, who's the popsicle? I was done. So I'm pretty excited to see Evan Peters now. I wonder how this is going to change things. I wonder what we're going to see in future MCU movies now that he's here. Will the X-Men get closer and closer to happening now that we have Evan Peters in this reality? And what other surprises do they have in store? I wonder if this is the surprise cameo Elizabeth Olsen was talking about, because it was awesome. But I think just because we knew from the leaks and all of that, it was sort of like, well, we already knew that. But still, I'm excited. So, next episode should be interesting. Cannot wait. Let me know your thoughts below. As always, make sure you are subscribed. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Let me know what you're most looking forward to. What do you think of Agnes? What do you think of Pietro returning? Leave it all in the comments below. But if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, what are you waiting for? Hit that like, comment, share, all that good stuff. On the road to 18,000 subscribers, let's get to it. I'll see all of you next time. I got the Servant video coming later, so make sure you're subscribed for that. As always, stay safe, stay positive, my friends.